Tomorrow is the 10-year anniversary of the flood of 2008. It's a day that impacted almost everyone here in the Wabash Valley. Storm Team 10's Chris Piper talked to people about that day. He joins us now live to talk about what they remember.
Yeah, Patrice and Rondrell, I'm live right now at Fairbanks Park. Here on the Wabash River, this is one of the first places that we saw some of the impacts of this flooding, but as many of you know, it went much farther than just the river.
The 100-year flood, that's what some people call it, because they hadn't seen anything like it before.
You couldn't train for that. Yeah. You couldn't plan for that, because that was beyond anything. You could go into this county, no one alive could tell you that they had seen a flood like that.
J.D. Kessler works for Vigo County Emergency Management. He remembers that day well because the river wasn't the only place that flooded.
It was just a real unique kind of flooding, and it was because of that huge downpour and no place for the water to go because of the ground saturation.
And because of that, people like Eric Michaels, who didn't live anywhere near the river, still felt the effects of the flood.
The water hadn't come up so high to where it was devastating. It was probably maybe halfway up the driveway or so at that point, but you knew it was going to get worse, especially when you take a look at the radar and see that the rain wasn't going to stop anytime soon.
Michael's parents' house was lucky, only taking minor damage. He says his biggest takeaway from the flood was just how important it is to have an exit plan.
No matter what kind of natural disaster that you could encounter, probably you should always have some sort of exit plan. How do you get out of your house if there's a flood, if there's a fire, if there's a tornado?
But the good news is Michael's knows that flood helped everyone be a little more prepared.
It was a real eye-opener, and it was really a test of what we had spent a couple years trying to get trained for and trying to make plans for.
Now, being prepared for a flood like that isn't the easiest thing, but making sure your family knows where to go in a situation like that can make all the difference. But for now, reporting live in Terre Haute, Chris Piper, Storm Team 10.